Welcome to the Given Experience. Here are some safety instructions that you should follow if you want to come back roughly as you were before.
Roughly.
Hello, this is your harness.
When you arrive on site, the guides will provide you with a complete harness set that you should use the next following days.
Mm-hmm.
Put on your harness. Step into your harness as if stepping into a diaper.
What? We all know how to do that.
And tighten the three buckles until the harness fits tightly around your waist and legs. Examine the knots to make sure they are tight. Allow the guides to check that the harness is put on correctly.
If your hair is long or crazy, attach your hair properly. If you are wearing glasses or a hat, get ready for some reasonable wind.
Now, get ready to attach yourself to the cable. There are two cords attached to your harness, a long safety rope, and a short and flat strap. The strap connects to the roller via a carabiner, supporting your weight. Always attach your safety rope to the cable first. This is an important safety protection when standing on a high platform. Open the carabiner by turning the screw and pushing it down. Once you click your carabiner onto the cable and release the screw, it will close itself automatically. Place the roller onto the cable with the triangle pointing down and the brake pointing backwards. Attach the harness strap to the roller by inserting the carabiner through both holes in the bottom of the roller and then closing the carabiner. Always double check if the carabiner closed properly by squeezing it.
Not good.
Warning, inverting the rope and the strap may cause a serious accident.
Good. Good.
Allow the guides to check that you are correctly attached to the cable. Always check if the cable you want to take is marked with a green tape. The cable marked with a red tape means it is a cable to return. In case you end up taking the wrong cable, always jump to the other end to make sure people do not go gliding whilst you are still on it. Then you can pull back, hand over hand, and take the cable marked with the green tape.
Wrap one hand over the top of the roller and put one hand on the strap. This will allow you to steer. If your body begins to twist, you can correct the twist and face forward again by applying gentle pressure, turning the carabiner left or right. Make sure your hand is partly on the roller and partly on the brake so you don't touch the cable while you're gliding. When given the okay, walk slowly down the stairs until you are sitting relaxed, suspended in the air. Takeoff is then automatic. Be careful not to let your hair or hands touch the cable while you're gliding. On the roller, you'll find a rubber brake attached to it that you can press or squeeze while gliding if you want to stop. Do not pull on the safety rope by mistake because you will brake unintentionally and not reach the other side. For landing, if you are unable to land on the platform, simply grab the cable with your hand to avoid rolling backwards once the roller reaches zero speed. If you have begun to move backwards too quickly to grab the cable safely, let yourself go until you stop naturally, and then pull yourself to the platform, hand over hand. Take as much time as you need. After landing, landing, the first thing you always do is attach your safety rope to the cable marked with yellow tape. Before you remove the roller, you are therefore always attached with one carabiner.
Remember this tip. Your safety rope is first on. First off.
To consider it a smart way to access the canopy, not a pure amusement activity, as you will see more animals when you are still or hidden than while gliding. In the treehouses and in the forest, please try to keep quiet, for your noises scare your animal hosts. Apart from an emergency situation, night gliding is not an option. It is dangerous as a branch might have fallen on the cable and you would scare the animals away before dawn.
Please be cautious and always double check your equipment. Don't hesitate to ask a guide to check if you have any doubts and refer to the instruction folder located in your treehouse.
Before takeoff, always check to make sure that there are no monkeys or gibbons on the cable. We want you to have animal encounters of a different kind. Enjoy this new perspective of the canopy. You are protecting the forest.